The similar view has been taken by the another division bench in Rajendra Singh versus State of UP and others. In the said case also, the disciplinary proceeding was dispensed with without any plausible reason. The only reason mentioned in the order was that the departmental inquiry shall consume sufficient time, and on the said ground the rule was invoked. This court set aside the order of the disciplinary authority and held as under. Here in the present case, the disciplinary authority had recorded its satisfaction, but it is well settled that satisfaction has to be based on German grounds and not ipsa dixit of the disciplinary authority. Here, the only ground to dispense with the inquiry is that if the writ petitioner appellant is allowed to continue in service, a departmental inquiry shall consume sufficient time, and therefore such continuance will have bearing on the morale of the other police personnel. We are of the opinion that the ground recorded by the disciplinary authority while dispensing with the inquiry is not German, nor is it on any material that may be relevant. As such, the ground set forth cannot justly dispensing the inquiry at all. The provisions contained under Rule 8 have been incorporated, keeping in view of the provisions of Article 311 of the Constitution of India. The power conferred on the authority to dispense with an inquiry in a given situation where it is reasonably not practicable to hold an inquiry has been envisaged therein. The apex court in the case of Union of India and another versus Tulsiram Patel, SCC 398, had the occasion to consider the scope of the aforesaid provision, and the apex court laid down the test of reasonableness in the said case to be reflected by the authority while proposing to dispense with an inquiry. Paragraph 130 of the said decision is reproduced below. Thus, whether it was practicable to hold the inquiry or not must be judged in the context of whether it was reasonably practicable to do so. It is not a total or absolute impracticability which is required by clause. What is requisite is that the holding of the inquiry is not practicable in the opinion of a reasonable man taking a reasonable view of the prevailing situation. It is not possible to enumerate the cases in which it would not be reasonably practicable to hold the inquiry, but some instances by way of illustration may, however, be given. It would not be reasonably practicable to hold an inquiry where the government servant, particularly through or together with his associates, so terrorize, threatens, or intimidate witnesses who are going to give evidence against him with fear of reprisal as to prevent them from doing so, or where the government servant by himself or together with or through other threatens, intimate and terrorize the officer who is the disciplinary authority or member of his family so that he is afraid to hold the inquiry or direct it to be held. It would also not be reasonably practicable to hold the inquiry where an atmosphere of violence or of general indiscipline and insubordination prevails, and it is immaterial whether the concerned government servant is or is not a party to bringing about such an atmosphere. In this connection, we must bear in mind that numbers coax and terrify while an individual may not. The reasonable practicability of holding an inquiry is a matter of assessment to be made by the disciplinary authority. Such authority is generally on the spot and knows what is happening. It is because the disciplinary authority is the best judge of this that clause of Article 311 makes the decision of the disciplinary authority on this question final. A disciplinary authority is not expected to dispense with a disciplinary inquiry lightly or arbitrarily or out of ulterior motives or merely in order to avoid the holding of an inquiry or because the department's case against the government servant is weak and must fail.